According to Harriet Nyakake, the Toro Kingdom Deputy Prime Minister, the Empaako Festival is going to be a forum to teach the people, especially the youth, about norms and tradition.
Protecting our environment, traditions and cultural heritage. And as Toro Kingdom or as a cultural institution, we are supposed to protect, promote and preserve our culture.
Every year, we keep on adding on one day. But the package we have for 14 days, we have it. But every year we unveil a different activity, a different idea, to make sure until we reach the 14 days.
Empaako is a naming system practiced by the Batoro, Bunyoro, Batuku, Batagwenda, and Banyabindi, whereby children are given one of the 12 names shared across the communities in addition to their given and family names. Addressing a person by his or her Empaako name is a positive affirmation of social ties. It can be used as a greeting or a declaration of affection, respect, or honor and love.
We need to appreciate ourselves. If we don't appreciate ourselves, no one else will appreciate us. And by so doing, when people come to that festival, they learn a lot. And they see a lot.
Use of Empaako can diffuse tension or anger. It also sends a strong message about social identity and unity, plus peace or reconciliation. The Toro Kingdom Deputy Prime Minister says Empaako Festival will help people to learn more about the kingdom's culture.
It's one way of marketing our culture and marketing our kingdom and, of course, marketing ourselves. And usually I see people coming, they make a lot of money. It's one way of making money and, of course, of learning this and that.
The festival is one of the activities that usher in Empaako celebrations. According to the Kingdom Deputy Prime Minister, they will also use this chance to mobilize the subjects for the coming coronation due to take place in September. Apart from Empaako naming, the festival will also include traditional games, telling of traditional stories, preparing of traditional foods, among others.
We have Empaako naming and we have cultural education. It's also an event. Then we have our local traditional games. We have Akabera Kenge.
Harriet Nakake praised the youth for organizing this year's festival. Report by Jonathan Singwire for the news.